tangent galvanometer. A. To determine the reduction factor of a tangent galvanometer and the horizontal intensity of Earth's magnetic field using a tangent galvanometer. Apparatus: tangent galvanometer, commutator, rheostat, regulated DC power supply, ammeter, key, and connecting wires. Tangent galvanometer consists of a coil of insulated copper wire wound on a circular non-magnetic frame. When a current is passed through the circular coil, a magnetic field is produced at the center of the coil, which is perpendicular to Earth's magnetic field. Since the needle is under the action of these two perpendicular magnetic fields, it is deflected from the mean position. Principle. The working principle behind the tangent galvanometer is the tangent law. When a bar magnet is suspended in two magnetic fields, B and BH, the magnet comes to rest, making an angle theta with the direction of BH as shown in the figure. This is called the tangent law in magnetism. Theory. Usually, tangent galvanometer is arranged in such a way that the horizontal component of Earth's magnetic field is in the direction of the plane of the coil. When a current flows through the circular coil, the magnetic needle is under the action of two mutually perpendicular fields. If theta is a deflection of the needle, then according to the tangent law, B is equal to BH tan theta, where BH is the horizontal intensity of Earth's magnetic field and B is a field generated by the current carrying circular coil. If I is a current passing through the coil of radius A with n number of turns, then the field generated by the coil at the center is B is equal to mu 0 ni by 2a, where mu 0 is a permeability of free space, which is equal to 4 pi into 10 raised to minus 7 Henry meter raised to minus 1. Equating these two equations, we get BH tan theta is equal to mu 0 ni by 2a. The reduction factor of tangent galvanometer, K, can be defined as K is equal to 2abh by mu 0 n is equal to I by tan theta. From this expression, horizontal intensity of Earth's magnetic field, BH, can be written as BH is equal to mu 0 nk by 2a. Procedure. Preliminary adjustments. Adjust the leveling screws to make the plane of the coil vertical. The compass box alone is rotated so that its 90-90 line is in the plane of the coil. The tangent galvanometer as a whole is rotated so that the aluminium pointer reads 0-0 line in the compass box. Now, the tangent galvanometer is in the magnetic meridian of Earth. Determination of reduction factor and horizontal intensity of Earth's magnetic field. The positive terminal of the power supply is connected to the positive end of ammeter via the key and then to the one end of the rheostat. The negative terminal of the supply and the top end of the rheostat are connected at the first and the third terminals of the commutator. The two ends of the tangent galvanometer are connected at the second and the fourth terminals of the commutator. Now, the entire connection will be as shown in the figure, where K is a key, E is a battery, A is a meter, RH is a rheostat, C is a commutator, and the TG is a tangent galvanometer. Select the number of turns in the coil. Allow a suitable current in the circuit by adjusting the rheostat and inserting the key K. For better and more accurate results, the current through the galvanometer is adjusted until the galvanometer shows deflection in between 30 and 60 degrees. The corresponding deflection on the compass box is noted. Reverse the current using the commutator and again note the readings. The entire experiment can be repeated for different values of current and by changing the number of turns in the tangent galvanometer. Applications. Tangent galvanometer can be used for measuring small currents. It is used for the determination of horizontal intensity of Earth's magnetic field.